I question whether those persistent herbicides are that persistent if you're composting well. So you have to find somewhere where it's good compost. And I think they'll break down fine. I've looked them up. They don't seem to be that persistent, no more than any normal herbicide. If they're spraying herbicide on crop, then they're killing the crop. So it's not likely that you're going to get hay or straw that's been killed by herbicide before it's cropped. So normally herbicide is used to prevent weeds growing in crop or around areas where weeds are not wanted. And that material is not likely to be the mulch material you're purchasing. But to answer your questions, if you wanted to spread the compost a long way with a compost tea, you've got to oxygenate that tea very, very well. You've got to make sure you start off with really good compost. You've got to look at it with a microscope to make sure there's a lot of beneficial organisms and a lot of diversity of beneficial organisms in that compost. Then you've got to oxygenate it with air blowing through the liquid, the same volume of air every minute to the same volume of liquid. So, you know, if you're doing 20 litres of liquid, you've got to have 20 litres of air every minute bubbling through that for 24 to 36 hours. And then you've got to spray it on within 6 to 8 hours. So you can do it, but it's a little bit technical if you move into the compost tea direction. Better off find some really good compost, better off find some good clean mulch. If possible, hay fields, I don't mind hay fields at all, even though they've got seed in it, because I get past the seed, because I don't think you've got a problem. You're in you know, improving the germination condition. And if you want to layer it all with compost, you're going to have an incredible germination condition. It's not going to favor weeds. But if you want to grow all your own mulch, if you go for the John Jevons biointensive method, they talk about 60% of the area being in a carbon crop for mulch. Now that can be things like corn can be used as a carbon crop, so that gets you get a yield and a carbon crop. It can be things like broad beans, fava beans in the winter, so that's a crop and a carbon crop. But it starts to limit what you can grow. So there's so many different ways you can garden, and they all work if you've got a passion. You don't have to put that much compost on, but I can hear what you want to do. You want to really bring the production up in your 20 foot by 20 foot garden. You really don't want to use a lot of it for growing mulch. You're worried that you're in a very toxic area that's got a lot of herbicide residual. You're trying to get away from all that. Well, let me give you another method. You can use a smaller amount of compost and just put it around the individual crop seedlings or down the crop rows if you're laying out seeds. And you can use a mulch imposition job where you get a cover crop on the garden and you work in the cover crop. Now, like I say, there's so many different ways that you can garden organically, and they all work if you've got a passion. And I've researched a lot and I like this one, right? And I'm going to give you reference here to a method called companion planting, successful gardening in an organic way. Now, it's by a lady called Gertrude Franck. She's an older lady. I think she would have passed on by now. She's an old German lady. It's translated into English. I've Googled it to make sure you can get it online. And I think I could get it online for free. It just comes up. So it's Gertrude, G-E-R-T-R-U-D, and Frank, F-R-A-N-C-K. And it came up when I spelled it wrong. So it should come up pretty easy if you spell it right. And it's the title of the book. And I read it years ago, and I've used this method. It works great, and it reduces all your problems because you're growing mulch in position as you're growing vegetables in the same place. So Companion Planting, Successful Gardening the Organic Way by Gertrude Franck, translated from the German by transcript. It's Thorson Publishers Limited, Wellingborough, Northamptonshire, Thorson Publishers Incorporated, New York. So we're talking about an American publication. This first published in Germany, and we've got the German name for it. I'm not going to try and pronounce it. Looks a bit hard for me. It was first published in April in Great Britain, obviously is the translation, in 1983. Second impression, October 1983, and then third in 1986. And I think it's a wonderful book. I think it's a great book. Now, what Gertrude does is he actually plants a cover crop continuously all the time and never has any empty beds in the garden. And she plants her vegetables at the same time and cuts them as a miniature chop and drop to the vegetables. I call it cover crop gardening. And if you're not using an area, it goes on a bit higher and you cut it later when you plant into it. But you never have any empty space in the garden. It continues to fertilize the garden non-stop. You're in the Mediterranean area, so it'll work summer and winter with different cover crops for each year, season. And I think that's your answer. And I'm glad to be able to give it to you and share it with everybody else as well. Check it out. Gertrude had some great ideas there, and she grew great gardens.